Well, now to a CBS 4 iTeam investigation that will make you think about something you likely carry with you most of the time. Did you know your cell phone could be used against you? It could be used to spy on what you're doing and who you're with, all without you ever knowing. CBS 4 iTeam investigator Stephen Stock shows you how.
In a nation of 309 million people, officials estimate...
Hey, man, what's up?
There are as many as 200 million cell phones.
Hello.
Hey.
But all this high-tech communication hides a dark and troubling danger.
I don't think the general public is aware of how insidious it can be.
Tim Wilcox owns and runs one of the premier private investigative companies in the country.
It takes about 90 seconds to download the spyware. You're in business.
It's a lurking danger that turns your cell phone into a secret listening device.
There could be anywhere from 3 to 5 or 6 million cell phones that are infected with spyware.
Spyware, otherwise called malware, can be found through a simple search on the internet, loaded into your phone in a matter of minutes or even seconds, and then turn your cell phone against you.
I put a run-of-the-mill $70 malware on this phone.
Daniel Smith is an expert at finding and getting rid of malware on all kinds of computers and cell phones.
That right there is the file name that's controlling my phone.
Smith demonstrated for the iTeam how easy it can be to install and listen in using this malware, and how hard it is to detect the malware.
This is what we're looking for. This small little file right here. That's it. It's four little lines.
The instructions hide a program that allows the person who installed it on your phone to take every bit of information from your cell phone, your pictures, your personal addresses, your data, your life. To find out exactly how it does work, the CBS 4 iTeam bought and installed one version of spyware on anchor Jawan Strader's BlackBerry with his knowledge.
Can't believe I'm doing this right now.
Activation success.
We could intercept and read all of Jawan's emails, read all of his text messages, see all of his addresses.
Here it says Jawan.
I got alerts on my phone.
It's just like it reads on my phone.
Every time Jawan got a call, an email, or a text. Even in a meeting, behind closed doors, with news director Cesar Aldama and assistant news director Nick Bourne, even with the BlackBerry turned off, I could still dial in. The phone would beep once, then go dark, and then I could listen into the conversation. I could listen in and hear every word, even though I was several miles away, and except that we told them, they never knew we were listening. We also use the spyware to track our expert Daniel Smith's movements in real time in Indiana while we sat in Miami. All of this is illegal in the United States without a court order or warrant.
To learn more about the risk associated with spyware on your cell phone, we came here to Purdue University in West Lafayette, Indiana, to talk to one of the world's leading researchers into cybersecurity.
It is a monitor of you, right.
Purdue Assistant Professor Richard Mislan researches just about anything you can think of when it comes to cell phones. He says this kind of spyware technology is limited only by a phone's capabilities.
The phones are getting more advanced. And so when that happens, obviously there are more threats to be had or more attacks to be or exploits to be had on those phones.
In fact, the federal government is using this technology to check out American citizens without a warrant. The iTeam learned of a half dozen cases around the country where federal magistrates were asked to throw out cases because federal agents had tracked people in real time through their cell phone, without a hearing, without a warrant, without even legal probable cause.
It's an incredibly intrusive thing for the government to be able to track you.
Jay Stanley heads the Technology and Liberty Program at the American Civil Liberties Headquarters in Washington, D.C.
The government is trying to claim they should be able to get location information about your phone, both where you've been in the past and also in some cases to track you in real time, without going through the Fourth Amendment and showing a probable cause that you're involved in wrongdoing and getting a warrant.
So far, in all but one of the federal cases we reviewed, magistrates, judges, even an appeals court, have ruled against the federal government and for requiring proof of probable cause.
If I had told somebody in 1975, you know what? In 30 years, every American, practically, is going to be carrying a tracking device with them that tells the government everywhere they go, live in real time. That person would say, oh, I guess that means that the Soviet Union is going to win the Cold War.
Now, Tim Wilcox's company found 500 different types of spyware on cell phones in just the last 3 months alone. So how can you protect yourself? First, always use a password to get into your phone and change it regularly. Second, never leave your cell phone out of your sight in a public environment, even at work. And third, never open an email attachments that you don't know the origins of, especially with your cell phone. And by the way, when we were done, yes, we did remove the spyware from Juwan Strader's phone. He's very happy about that.
This is scary. And so if somebody gets you open the wrong attachment,
that's right,
they can figure out your password and do anything.
I can actually send you an email with a Trojan horse, and you open it as an attachment, it opens up, and that spyware is on your phone, and you don't even know it. Millions of lines of code, unless you know what to look for, you can't find it.
I tell you what I thought was the craziest is that you could listen in on that entire conversation and
they never knew it, except that I told you that. In fact, one lady in California found out her husband was trying to divorce her, and he knew about conversations she was having with her lawyer.
Wow.
He was listening in.
Wow.
On her cell phone.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. All right.
Yep. Thanks,
Stephen. Thanks. Very eye-opening. And if you have a story that you would like the iTeam to investigate, give them a call at 305-471-0404. You can also email them via our website at cbs4.com/iTeam.